प्रारंभ कीजिए।
थैंक यू चेयरमैन सर फॉर गिविंग द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक ऑन द थ्री रेवोल्यूशनरी बिल्स बीइंग कंसिडर्ड टुडे इन दिस ऑगस्ट हाउस। सर फर्स्टली आई मस्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट द स्टेप्स टेकन टू
गवर्नमेंट्स
एम्प्लॉयमेंट सिक्योरिटी।
प्लीज बी ब्रीफ
सर।
जी जी
बोथ इन फिजिकल टर्म एज वेल एज फाइनेंशियल एंड सेल्फ डेवलपमेंट एस्पेक्ट। सर थ्रू दिस बिल by issuing an appointment letter mandatory by the employer can considerably aid in the formalization of their employment. Sir, as we can see ourselves from this reforming enactment, our honorable prime minister is building a strong backbone for our country's economy with the laborers and workers being brought into the forefront of national building with a much confident and stable workforce. So considering the current economic turbulence, this bill will exponentially help in the growth of our GDP. Sir, through you sir, I would like to clarify to honorable minister for few to add few general apprehensions about certain classes. Sir, in classes number 55-4 which states that appropriate government has the power to reject or modify the award given under this code, it is my understanding that the Standing Committee on Labour had suggested that such power vested with the appropriate government is against the principle of separation of power. And number two, class number 92-1 states that appropriate government has the power to withdraw and transfer any pending proceedings under this code to another tribunal, which I feel again is against the very purpose of the bill. The proceedings when transferred from one state to another, for example, it would hamper the justice since the same may get affected due to regional politics. And also, I would like to share few suggestions regarding this bill, sir. Sir, number one, with almost 75% of the labour workforce employed in the construction industry being migrant labour, it is required that contractors have to register their workers under ISM Act. My suggestion to the government. The government should make it mandatory and routine audits and inspections should be conducted by the concerned agencies to enforce the same. And number two, the contractors also should be given various enterprising incitements and support models by the government, motivating the contractors to adhere and ensure mandatory registration for all labour. Sir, number three, in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, migrant labourers who predominantly make their livelihoods by daily wages need to be inspired both financially and emotionally. Sir, that migrant labourers' livelihood by providing the supply of dry rations from the construction welfare fund, sir. And also, similarly, medical checkups and assistance during pandemic can also be supported from the construction welfare fund, sir. And moreover, sir, 50,000 families in my state are depends upon the cine industry for the livelihoods. Now, sir, the cine workers, in case of their meeting with the accidents on shooting spots, at this juncture, I would like to bring the notice of honourable minister that necessary notifications shall be placed to widen the definition of contract labours in Class 2-1M of the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Code 2020 by specifically mentioning cinema and entertainment industry. And finally, I conclude with the quote of our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhiji: obedience to the law of bread labour will bring about a signal revolution in the structure of society. Through this bill, our honourable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, is creating revolution, strengthening and restructuring our Indian society towards the creations of the new India. Through these words, I support this.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.